Namaskar friends, today I am going to tell you how you can approach the Polity subject, which has a very good average in prelims as well as in mains in case of UPSC or any other state service, or even if you are appearing for SSC, CGL or HS level, whatever it is. Many of our students or aspirants do not have a background of Polity or something like that. Many of our engineering friends are appearing for the civil services examination and they found no clue how to approach for the examination or for the Polity subject itself. So I am going to tell you how a student who has no background regarding Polity or any arts subjects can approach the Polity as well as they can excel at it. Now most of you are aware of the fact that there is many books in the market. My personal favorite is this one, Indian Polity by M. Lakshmikant. Many of you have this book either electronically, that's mean you have a PDF version, or this is third version. Time of this video is June 2018 and in the market if you find you will get fifth edition of the same book on the fifth edition with some extra chapters and maybe some extra fact. So many of our students when start preparing for this Polity, they get stuck after 2 to 3 chapters. They give their best energy, time and everything, but they still could not figure out how to read after chapter 3. Because within chapter 3, they found it very much less interesting chapter or subject. But I have few ways, few techniques, which I am going to tell you in this video, that how you can overcome this situation. Friends, if you have this book either electronically or in hand, all you need to do not ever start from the first chapter. That's the thing. If you start from the first chapter, that is historical background, making of the constitution, salient features of the constitution, of course these chapters are important. Many times UPSC questions are asked from here. If you think that you are going to complete this whole book, take my suggestion, work with it, and if you find my suggestion is not up to the mark, you can simply go for other suggestions or other ways. So I will suggest you to start from a very easy topic. What is that? In my Polity book, that is Lakshmikant for third edition, in this book, if you go to the content page, and in the content, not in the constitution, in the content, part 7, constitutional bodies are there. Whenever you start this book for the first time in your life, or if you have read once or twice in some in this book beforehand watching this video, I would suggest that go for constitutional bodies first. Because constitutional bodies, that's mean election commission, UPSC, SPSC, finance commission, national commission for SC, ST and advocate general, attorney general, all of these constitutional bodies more or less at least 80 to 90% are same. Only difference is their work. How is they same? They retire at 65 years of age. Most of them cannot accept jobs after the retirement. They have their specific sphere of performance. That's mean election commission has to conduct elections of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha in case of central election commission, and presidents and vice president, etc. In case of state election commission, they are entrusted with the conducting of election of local bodies like panchayat and municipalities. Everywhere the scene is same, recruited by president, only SPSC chairman and members are recruited by governor. All are removed by president, all have their job security and more or less the same. Comptroller general checks or, you know, audits those papers of various commissions, or not commissions, various corporate bodies under government of India, or even if they are not under government of India, CAG can also audit other private corporations also. This is the first step. You read these chapters in a day. Do not just remember, you don't have to memorize everything. That's a very bad notion. Look, our brain, how it works? Well, actually, I don't know because I'm not a scientist. But I found it, if you impose something on your brain, it will not work. It will not do it. Because British rule was imposed on us, we revolted against it, and after the 200 years of time gap, we finally removed it. Many things which are imposed on us, we do not conform with it and we rebel against it. So do not impose this to be memorized in your brain. What you will do? Just read it for first time, second time, third time, just like simple, you are reading another story. If you read this thing, first you read these full chapters. Then you come to non-constitutional bodies. What do you read in the constitutional bodies? Age and retirement and their function, sphere of functions and their safeguards. All these three. And of course, you should remember their articles. If you are appearing for a state civil service examination, if you are appearing for UPSC, article is not that important. Non-constitutional bodies, under their headings, you need to read only National Human Rights Commission and State Human Rights Commission, Central Vigilance Commission, Central Information Commission and Lokpal and Lokayukta. Only five chapters. You don't need to read everything. Then you will find other constitutional dimensions, political dynamics. You don't need to read those chapters. This will not do any good to you. I suggested you constitutional bodies, non-constitutional bodies. Now come to part 5, Panchayati Raj. Part 5 in not in the constitution, part 5 in the index of this book. Panchayati Raj and urban local governments, that's the municipalities, read those. Then come to and union territories and special areas, you don't need to read that. I have never seen a question is asked on from these chapters. That's mean union territories or scheduled and tribal areas. I never seen. But scheduled and tribal areas, there are few questions which are asked on the were asked in the past in UPSC. What were the questions? Only the schedule numbers, that one under which schedule in the constitution tribal areas are mentioned, like that thing. Only one or two lines. You don't need to read the full chapter and read all and every other subsection, section. Or no, just these things. Then you come to part 3, central government, and part 4, state government. How to read that? First you read president. Then you read governor. Because president and governor more or less are the same. In case of central level, it's president. In case of state level, it is governor. Then you read vice president, because there is no vice governor, so only read vice president. Then you read prime minister, then chief minister. Both of them are same. One is in the central level, another is at the state level. Then read parliament, and on the same date or maybe next date, read state legislature. Because both they have same functions, same procedure, same 0 hours and all other things. Only parliamentary committees and other things are vary from central to state. And then go for Supreme Court. On the day you read Supreme Court, on the very next hour, you should read High Court and subordinate courts. That's all. You don't need to read anything more than that. That will waste your time. Then you read System of Government. Here you have to read all the chapters. That's in parliamentary system, federal system, center-state relations, interstate relations, emergency provisions. And you don't need to read special status of J&K and special provisions for the some states. For the prelim purpose, at least from here. Of course, there are many, you know, hot topics regarding J&K, Article 35A and all other things. You will have to read those things for main purpose. But not from this book. And then you come to the last section or the first section in this book. You should read first fundamental rights. And what you should read in the fundamental rights? 7 point in my book, it is chapter 7. So you should read 7.1 table. There was a table in this book. Let me show you. I'm not sure how well you can see it. There is a table in this chapter 7.1. Here you will find every fundamental rights is written here and their description is there. All you need to read this and this description. And the table goes on this side of this page also. So this. All you need to read this and then go to the writs, where if a authority or any individual person have broken your fundamental rights, you can go to the Supreme Court or High Court for the remedies. That is writs and types and scope. There are 5 writs: habeas corpus, mandamus, certiorari, quo warranto and prohibition. After fundamental rights, you should read DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policy, very easy subject, but you don't need to remember even one article. But if you are appearing for state services examination, there could be many articles can be asked from DPSP, like Article 44, 48A, like this topics. Then fundamental duties. All you need to remember in the fundamental duties is how many fundamental duties are there, that is 11. And which article and part is associated with it, Article 51A. Okay. And then come to the making of the constitution. Just read about it, get an idea. Do not go get deep into it. And after that, preamble of the constitution, salient features of the constitution are very important. All you need to know what are the salient features, how it is unitary, how it is federal. But remember, Indian constitution is a federal constitution. So the chapters I have mentioned in this video, I think is enough for the purpose of prelims as well as mains. Just read this one or twice and you have to, you know, memorize these things because these are very important. But do not impose it. Just read it once, twice, thrice and again and again and again and again. What happens if you impose that you have to read or memorize these for your examination? Your brain will definitely make various other excuses. That's when I'm getting sleeping now. Oh, it's very bored. I have another work. I should read another book. Your brain will always skip the task of memorizing. Just do it, but in a simple way. If you take my opinion, you should read these chapters or books as many times as possible, at least 30 times. Not to memorize this. Just read for 30 times and after 30 times you will get clarity on these topics, on these subjects, and you should solve the questions. Now, how the questions are asked in the UPSC? Let me tell you. UPSC asks from, if you read this book, you will get definitely sure shot questions from this book. This is for sure. But from which topic you will be asked the questions? The questions will be asked from the topic which are in the current or in the news in the market. Example, there are many states where BJP is not getting full majority. They have to take other support to form a government in the state. But as per the convention, the largest party in the state is called for forming a government. But in many cases, governors are calling BJP even if they are not largest party in the state assembly. So, governor is shaping the formation of government with his discretionary power. That case, governor is a very hot topic currently this time. This time is June 2018, I'm talking about. So, there was a question regarding governor in the UPSC prelims in the year 2018. And remember, as a UPSC is a central level examination or whatever you may call it, it's not a state level examination. So, questions, there are every chance that questions will be asked from President, because President is a central level authority, Parliament or its functionaries, Supreme Courts, because Supreme Court, of course, it's an integrated judiciary, but Supreme Court, these few constitutional bodies, election commission like that, the questions will come from the central level authorities like these. But governor was in news recently, that's why a question from governor also appeared. If you follow the way I told you in this video, you will definitely find that Indian polity is a very interesting subject to read. From my channel, you will get many classes regarding how to how to read constitutional bodies and all other things, what to read, how to appear or approach those questions. I'll tell you in the next courses. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day ahead.